at your side, with offices in Pierre, Mitchell, Watertown, Sioux Falls, and Rapid City.
In the Army National Guard, family means everything.
They really appreciate what she's done as a sister as well as a soldier and, you know, supporting the country.
Our parents, they were really supportive that all five of us would join.
Family members that are soldiers in the Army National Guard inspire and influence, setting a path for others.
It's validating knowing that, you know, I kind of did my part to make sure this is what they actually wanted and that they feel the same way I do. I'm really proud that we get to help shape the future, and I know that my sisters are going to be amazing soldiers.
Serving part-time in the Army National Guard instills pride that you and your family will share in.
A lot of pride, and they're just out there doing something every day and then serving their country as well.
I got my education because of the Guard. I got to travel a little bit and experience a whole different culture.
Visit NationalGuard.com to learn more about part-time service. Sponsored by the South Dakota Army National Guard. Aired by the South Dakota Broadcasters Association and this station.
In Rapid City, you've got a friend in real estate. Hi, I'm Ellen Roach. When buying or selling your home or property, Will Dixon is the man to see.
Will invites you to experience the Keller Williams culture. Whether you're buying or selling, he can assist you through the entire process with a free market analysis and advise you on all your options. Will handles all phases of real estate and has built a track record for success. Call Will Dixon at Keller Williams Black Hills, 390-1140, and let him be your friend in real estate.
KIMM Rapid City and K294BT Rapid City, the Black Hills Sports Station, 106.7 FM and 1150 AM, Fox Sports, Rapid City.
Need to know.
In a little more than 2 hours from now, the Raiders and Rams will start Week 14 in Los Angeles. We still don't know who the starting quarterback for the Rams will be. It could be John Wolford. He's listed as questionable with a neck injury, but if he can't go, a report from ESPN says that Baker Mayfield, who was just claimed off of waivers from the Panthers this week, could get the start for the Rams tonight. Kickoff 8:15 Eastern time. Jaguars quarterback Trevor Lawrence missed another practice today because of his toe injury. Giants running back Saquon Barkley limited in practice because of a neck issue. While the Falcons are benching veteran quarterback Marcus Mariota in favor of rookie Desmond Ridder. Falcons have a bye in Week 14, so Ridder will get his first start against the Saints in Week 15. House Oversight Committee found Washington Commanders owner Dan Snyder fostered a toxic work environment and tried to interfere into investigations of the team, while WNBA star Brittany Griner freed from a Russian prison and on her way back to the States. I'm Dan Buck.
It's time for South Dakota's Sports Talk Show. This is the Nate Brown Show, featuring live callers, live interviews, and thought-provoking sports talk. From the biggest national names to the hottest local stories, welcome to the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City. Here's your host, Nate Brown.
Hey, everybody. Welcome in. How are you? Thanks for being here. Appreciate that. Hope you're having a solid Thursday. We're back and ready. It's always a great day in the Black Hills, and the Nate Brown Show is live here on Fox Sports Rapid City, the Black Hills Sports Station, South Dakota Sports Talk Show, ready to roll with some great guests today. John Stiegelmeyer is going to drop by, South Dakota State head football coach. A lot of times we get him in the 5 o'clock hour, so if you listen to this opening hour, you're lucky today, man. You get John Stiegelmeyer is going to join us live from Brookings, the Jackrabbits, number one seed in the FCS playoffs, hosting Holy Cross on Saturday. It's going to be on ESPN, a 10 a.m. Mountain Time start. Jack's trying to advance in the FCS playoffs against undefeated Holy Cross out of the Patriot League, coming all the way out to Brookings, South Dakota from Massachusetts. We'll talk to Coach Stig. A big honor today for John Stiegelmeyer, the head coach for the Jackson, his 26th season. A big honor. We're going to get to that coming up. So a great Thursday show, 106.7 FM, 1150 AM. Welcome in on the radio side. Also, ways you can listen and watch. Find us at foxsportsrapidcity.com. If you get out of range on the radio stuff, go to foxsportsrapidcity.com. The live stream always there from Dan in the morning to Doug in the afternoon, Colin in the midday, and then, of course, the Nate Brown Show. You've got us at foxsportsrapidcity.com. And here from 4 to 6 live weekdays, South Dakota Sports Talk Show. You can watch us now on Twitter, at Nate Brown Show. Follow us and watch us, and also on YouTube, The Nate Brown Show. So let's get after it. The Nate Brown Show brought to you in part by Black Hills Orthopedic and Spine Center, the expert team when it comes to orthopedic care. And I'll tell you, they take care of the weekend warrior to the elite athlete. You see them out there taking care of the athletes on the court and wrestling mat right now. That's the team at Black Hills Ortho. Okay, learn more at bhosc.com. When it comes to the best orthopedic care, better access, more options at Black Hills Orthopedic and Spine Center, bhosc.com. Start there. Let's get into the Thursday show. I told you Coach Stig's going to join us straight ahead, SDSU head football coach. Then we're going to go to a brand new guest, really good NFL writer. He's the Associated Press lead NFL writer, live from Florida, Rob Motti, for the first time. We'll get into Week 14 coming up. Brian Fisher's on the way, college football on Fox. He's on tap. We'll get into the whole scene of the transfer portal and a lot more there with Brian Fisher on the way. Craig Maddock tonight from Sioux Falls, SDPB Sports. Craig Maddock, East River meets West River. We haven't done that for a while. Let's get into that. Chris Dabner tonight, Rapid City Stevens boys basketball coach, back for another season, and the Raiders go on the road to start the season on the boys side to Pierre tomorrow night, and then Aberdeen Central on Saturday. Coach Stabner, what's it look like for the Raider boys? We'll get a preview from them, and it's a football pick'ems Thursday with Rob Kegron. We've got five NFL games and some interesting ones. My Broncos, 9-point underdogs at home. Your Vikings, two and a half point underdogs on the road. How about that? Rob Kegron coming in. Skybox Football Pick'ems Thursday. We'll get into this puppy, all right? Let's get going. 720-1067 is our number if you want to join us tonight. 720-1067, the studio line. Your take there. And also the Barron's Wilson text line ready to go. Direct text the show. 720-1067. That's the Barron's Wilson text line. Very active over the last couple of days. I always like that. And here's a way I want to start today's show. It's an interesting discussion I had yesterday. You know, a lot of times I talk sports outside of our daily work life here. You may wonder, okay, sometimes you need a little breather, but I'm talking sports a lot. So I go and I meet yesterday a college football player from East River, okay? He's originally from East River, and he played college football. And now he's out here doing business, okay? So now he's out here doing business. And I'm talking with him. We're having some, you know, discussions about local sports and all of that stuff. And the one big thing he told me is I took away and I said, I'm gonna discuss this on the show. As a matter of fact, I'm going to make a question of the day out of it because we've kind of beat around the bush here a little bit on this. We wade into the water a little bit on this topic, but we never quite get down to brass tacks, never quite hit it right between the running lights. And the one big takeaway, my discussion, so here it is. East River guy, played high school sports out there, and then went on to play college sports, college football player. He's now out here in Rapid City, and he looks at our youth sports scene, and he looks at our high school sports, and you know what he told me yesterday? He said, man, Nate, everybody's got to realize we've got really, really good athletes out here. That's what he told me. He goes, you know, growing up back East River and, you know, it's a, we got a culture back there and sports is a big thing. And, you know, we're really good in football and that whole thing. And he said, but you know what's happening? He said, now that I've been out here in Rapid City, people don't realize the great sports, the great athletes that are here in Rapid City, in West River. That didn't come from me, by the way, which I've been a West River transplant from Montana, by the way. I didn't do that East River thing. I know West River, Best River. Okay, so I've been here. I've been here a long time. This came from an East River guy, grew up playing there, grew up, played high school, good athlete, college player, so he knows what he's talking about. And he said, it's really, you know, statewide, you look at it and you say, Rapid City just, I don't think they get enough respect. I don't think they get enough attention for how many great athletes. And he's not talking just average. He said, there's some great athletes in Rapid City. Now, it's my takeaway. I said, I think that's right. And we try and do, you know, as good a job as we can interviewing them, highlighting them, talking to their coaches, talking about where players have been from here and where they've gone, trying to feature some of these players that are playing college, right? And we're going to do more of that. I think we're going to do more of that. So we try and highlight the local sports scene as best we can here, and a lot of folks have a part in that. But I think he's right in saying the rest of South Dakota doesn't think that West River slash, let's just say Rapid City, well, they just don't have as good athletes as Sioux Falls, right? Do you think that's a fair statement? Do you think the rest of the state says, yeah, the best athletes and the best teams and the best of the best really are in Sioux Falls? Rapid City, yeah, every now and then. Rapid City, every now and then. So I took away from that because I said, I think you're right. I don't think there is a wide range of a lot of respect for our Rapid City athletes and Rapid City sports, as a matter of fact. And sometimes we do that to ourselves. Honestly, sometimes we do that to ourselves, not just in Rapid City, but elsewhere around the state. How many times have I heard this? Well, if we had the facilities that Sioux Falls has, we would be way better. If we had the training programs that Sioux Falls had, we would be way better. If we had the money Sioux Falls has, we would be so much better. And you hear it here, and I hear it in all these other towns. As a matter of fact, it was the reason that the ESD broke away when we were playing high school football years ago. You know, the Pierce and the Yanktons and those teams that were competing in the AA level of football, they broke away because the storyline at every school was, we just can't be as good as Sioux Falls. We won't be as good as Sioux Falls. We need our own division. As a matter of fact, we need our own level. Thus, the creation of AAA football and AA football. That was the storyline years ago. I mean, we created a whole football class because everybody says we can't beat Sioux Falls. And I'm going to ask this question of the day as we start this show. On the local sports side, this is very interesting. It was a great discussion yesterday I had with this former college athlete who says, I'm from East River, and I'm seeing the athletes out here in Rapid City. There's a ton of them. There's a ton of great athletes. Why aren't we seeing as much success in some of the sports? Some sports we do fine. Some of the other sports, like football, not doing as fine. I'm going to ask you this question and see if we create our own mess. When it comes to high school sports, I'm asking you, the audience today, does Sioux Falls have way more advantages than the rest of the state? That's my question of the day. I want to ask the audience. We've been going round and round on Twitter today on the Nate Brown Show. I mean, you know, I'm getting ready for the show. I can't be getting distracted by all these tweets. Well, I'm getting in arguments. Imagine that. Twitter arguments? No. When it comes to high school sports, I ask you this question. You guys have been there, done that. You've had kids playing. You may have kids playing now. When it comes to high school sports, does Sioux Falls have way more advantages than the rest of the state, including Rapid City, to wherever, Aberdeen, down to Yankton, wherever? If you want to look at these AA schools, like we're into the AA basketball season right now, we're into wrestling season right now, does Sioux Falls have the advantages? Okay, that's my question. A lot of people are sounding off on Twitter, by the way. Let me know where you're at on it. I'd like to hear what you say, because that, I think, is the that's the line I hear a lot. Whenever something doesn't go our way, whenever we kind of struggle, maybe we don't win a state title, maybe we can't quite get as many teams into the state tournament, whatever it may be, the line I hear is, well, Sioux Falls has all the advantages. I'm not saying that it's totally wrong. Okay, I'm not going to be here. I'm not going to say their facility that they have out there at the Pentagon, okay, they have the field house, the Pentagon, that whole thing. They're going to have new outdoor fields when it comes to baseball, softball, soccer. I understand they have some good facilities. I understand that Sioux Falls has a big population. I mean, it's a big population base. Okay, there might be, I would say there's an advantage when it comes to sports and fielding great teams, competitive teams. Population helps, yes. I mean, we understand that. Okay, so I'm going to say Sioux Falls advantage, population. Just put it out there. There's one. What I'm trying to tell you is I believe the population is not the X factor. of why Sioux Falls has had great sports success. The population is not the X factor. Some people have told me, well, that's just the way it is. I mean, you got the population, you got the facilities, you got resources out there, and people are there funneling money in, Sanford and Avera. That's the end of the story. Nobody else can compete on a regular basis. And that's that same argument I heard years ago in football from the ESD, which I believe I don't want to say they bailed too quickly, but they bailed. And I believe that was the case when it comes to, well, we can't win anymore. We lost here a little bit. We can't win anymore. Case in point, Sioux Falls O'Gorman, smaller school out at Sioux Falls, Catholic school, yes, private, okay? Different scenario there, but Sioux Falls O'Gorman used to dominate in football. As a matter of fact, really good basketball, too. Sioux Falls O'Gorman dominated in football. The rest of the Sioux Falls schools all of a sudden started putting some things in place, started competing on a regular basis, and now O'Gorman, they're in the mix, but there's everyone else as well. I mean, there's everyone else as well. A lot of the Sioux Falls schools could have said, hey, O'Gorman, man, private, they can get this athlete. They, you know, they quote unquote, they recruit. I've heard that, right? they recruit. The Sioux Falls schools, yeah, we can't compete. They could have said that. I believe that's the line we tend to use now when maybe we don't have a brand new field house. Maybe we don't, and we need some facilities. I understand the Rapid City Sports Commission's coming together. We're trying to think about what's the best use of time, energy, resources. Okay, that's all going to be coming. It's all a process. But I'm going to tell you right now, I do believe that it's not the X factor, population and resources. I don't think that's the Sioux Falls winning formula. Here in Rapid City, can kids play sports? Can kids compete in tournaments? Can kids work on their craft and put in the time and energy? They can do all that. As a matter of fact, we have sports-specific training programs that have really ramped up our level. We've really ramped up. I think we're catching up. I don't think Sioux Falls, just by sheer size, well, they have size and they have some facilities. We act like we're just, you know, throwing hay bales here in Rapid City. I mean, wow, we don't even have football fields. I'm not buying that. Thanks for calling today, asking you if Sioux Falls has all the advantages over everyone else. You're live and you go ahead.
Well, I think they have some advantages, but like with the football situation, what would they have that would be more beneficial than what we have in football?
I don't think much. I mean, they have some fields, but we do too.
You know, like I get like basketball and soccer and those outdoor where they're building these indoor facilities and softball like out over there and stuff like for these guys. But like football, you got weight rooms. You got 100-yard field. I mean, you got places you go. So I don't know what the argument would be as far as Sioux Falls goes. We have the athletes. We just don't have kids when they get to be about 15, 16 years old, decide they want to go do something else. And I don't know how to change that.
I think you make a good point. Like some of these sports where, hey, you got to travel and you got to do this and you got to do that. Football's a different beast. Football is, hey, put in time, put in weight training, put in speed and conditioning, and put in football work, and you should be pretty good.
Right. I mean, it's not like, you know, like they just had volleyball tryouts, for God's sakes. Didn't volleyball just get over with? Now they got tryouts. And like our whole situation, that just gets frustrating. We had eighth graders try out for the basketball teams. If they were good enough to play sophomore level, they were going to move them up from middle school. Are our two high schools not big enough that we have to poach from middle school?
Yeah.
I mean, I'd be embarrassed to
That's
say.
That's interesting.
Right. Why do we have to go to the middle school to find athletes? We don't have any in our two high schools.
This college football player yesterday told me, he goes, there's athletes everywhere here. They're everywhere. He's from East River. He said, we have great athletes. My question is, are there enough of them? What happens to them?
I think there's enough of them. I just think the people, I think there's so many people that there's not enough supporting cast for them. People, if they're not the star, for some reason, in the past 15 years, 10, 15 years, we've taken an approach that if my kid isn't number one, they're not playing. Well, now we're not even playing? I mean, we're not even...
No, that's so it. I buy that. I've heard those stories, right?
What are they going to do if they're not playing then? Or we'll move. We'll go somewhere else. It's a mindset right now that needs to change in this community, and I don't know what it's going to take to do that. So
okay, I got you on that. I think a mindset, yes. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. I think a mindset does need to change. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and say today, okay, Sioux Falls doesn't have any advantage. I've argued with people on this on Twitter today. I mean, it went across the state here, over to Sioux Falls and everything else. And, you know, folks are getting into the argument. Sioux Falls has population. They have some resources, right? But that last caller just said, okay, so how did they get better than everyone else? Well, they have some big schools. We've got some pretty big schools. I mean, here in Rapid City, we got some pretty big schools. I know we have some great athletes. I'm here to tell you the mindset is a little bit of an issue. I do believe it. I'm not going to sit here and say we are just second fiddle to Sioux Falls and we don't have enough resources, we don't have enough facilities. We're just second fiddle. They just have way more advantages. You know what that is? It's excuses along the way. Both things can be true. Sioux Falls can have some nice things, but that's also not the X factor of why Sioux Falls has had a lot of success in whether it's high school football or whatever it may be. Because there's just a list of teams here. You want me to run through the list? How can Rapid City win some state wrestling at Stevens? Get into the state basketball championship back-to-back year, Stevens girls basketball. St. Thomas More girls basketball, unbelievably dominant. St. Thomas More boys basketball, 4 state championships. Stevens track, always right there. Have the best track athlete in the state, maybe the region right now. That's not just the fancy facilities, the resources. It's the competitiveness. It's the nature. It's the program. It's the culture. Just go through that. Stevens tennis, they just won on the girls' side. You know, I'll just run through all the sports. State boys soccer, Stevens just won the state championship. I mean, I can go through the list for you. Everybody likes saying, well, Sioux Falls has all these fancy things and facilities, and they have the tournaments at the Pentagon, and, man, they get really, really good when they're younger, and they get to play teams from Minneapolis and Omaha, and that makes them really, really good by the time. I'm not buying it. Let's make sure we can just beat the team across the street before we have to worry about winning against Omaha and Minneapolis and saying that that's what's going to make you better in high school. I was just at a youth basketball tournament this past weekend here in town. Saw some teams from Rapid City. They would do just fine. They were playing here in Rapid City. They would do just fine over there in Sioux Falls. I hate to break it to you. It's not about just the money, the advantages, the facilities. The Sioux Falls has everything, and we're just going to play second fiddle. I'm not buying it because Stevens girls basketball, Stevens boys soccer, Stevens girls soccer last year, state championship match, STM girls boys basketball. I mean, the list goes on. Stevens wrestling. Nobody's playing second fiddle in these programs. I think it's a deal. You know, people have always said Rapid City, we're just behind Sioux Falls. In certain ways, we have been. I'm not buying that overall athletically, high school sports, Sioux Falls has way more advantages, so we're just going to be coming in second. I'm not buying it. Let's see what your answers are. When it comes to high school sports, does Sioux Falls have way more advantages than the rest of the state? 87% of the audience here, this makes my case in point. 87% of the people voting on Twitter say, yes, they just have more of everything. Sioux Falls has all the advantages. They just have more of everything. 87%. 13% say, no, other cities can catch up. Just 13% of us kind of giving us a puncher's chance here. I'm not buying Sioux Falls just has everything, so they're going to be better. No way. Thanks for calling. You're live today, and you go ahead.
Hey, Nate. How are you enjoying the day?
I'm doing good, man. How about you?
Good. I'm good, yeah, good. You know, I agree with you partially.
Okay.
You look at the sports that Rapid City's, that Stevens has had success in. You mentioned track, basketball, soccer.
Wrestling,
Tennis, wrestling.
Yep.
You know, quite honestly, maybe with the exception of wrestling, you know, for soccer and track, you just kind of need a field and some good coaches. But you look at, like, football.
Yeah.
You look at football, and some of that stuff makes a difference, dude. You know, and playing teams from other parts of the country makes a difference.
You think
you know,
so?
I'm not saying that I want to have fifth grade football teams traveling to Chicago or New York to play or anything like that, but you know, it's a different level of competition.
I agree with that. Like, hey, maybe we should get out of our bubble, you know, some of these kids playing football, because then you find out, hey, maybe you're not as good as you think you are. I get that. I get that a little bit. But sometimes I think that gets overblown. Sometimes. I think that can get overblown.
I don't disagree. You know, and you can't look at professional sports teams. You can't spend your way to a good team, right?
Right.
I would say the same is true with high school sports. I think you really hit the nail on the head when you talked about culture. I think you have to look at why is the culture of track the way it is, the culture of wrestling, the culture of, you know, some of these other sports where there's been success.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the answer more than anything.
I got you, man. But I appreciate you getting in. Thanks for calling.
Have a great weekend.
All right. You too. Thanks for getting in. Okay, I'll continue this discussion. We got to get to Coach John Stiglmeyer. He's waiting in the wings, okay? South Dakota State head football coach. I want to continue this discussion. Some interesting stuff on the text line coming in. The Sioux Falls have all the advantages over everyone else when it comes to high school sports. John Stiglmeyer next from Brookings, South Dakota State head coach on the way.
Live callers, big time interviews, and breaking sports news. This is the Nate Brown Show on Fox Sports Rapid City.
Are creepy crawlers hanging around your house or maybe even in your house? Warren Chemical and Equipment Company has the answer for spiders, millipedes, crickets, saw bugs, and more. They carry professional-grade pest control products and applicators for do-it-yourself pest control, and they can advise you on how to use them. For professional hands-off pest control, call Warren Chemical and they'll handle your pest problems for you. Warren Chemical and Equipment Company. We kill bugs. Call us at 342-7644.
Whether you run the race, make the catch, cast a line, pitch a tent, or just look good doing it, Shields Rapid City has your gear. From athletic clothing from your favorite team, cold weather gear to keep you warm, to the best camping selection this side of the Black Hills, and the most stylish and functional women's outerwear and footwear, Shields has the widest selection of the best brands in the business. So when you're ready to get out, get in the game, or get going, get to Shields. Shields, we're right there with you at Rushmore Crossing in Rapid City.
Kelly Blue Book Instant Cash Offer from Denny Menholt Toyota. Use your phone. It's fast and easy. Pull up our website, click on Value Trade-In, scan your VIN, and tell us about your car. You are on your way to a no-hassle, no-commitment cash offer on your vehicle in under 5 minutes. Bring your vehicle and your Kelly Blue Book Instant Cash Offer to Denny Menholt Toyota and get cash or trade-in credit today. See you soon at Denny Menholt Toyota, Rapid City.
Hey, this is Rob Parker from The Odd Couple. Don't miss our show weeknights from 6 to 8 p.m. right here on Fox Sports Rapid City. And now we'll send you back to Rapid City Sports Talk Show, the Nate Brown Show.
Hey, welcome back in. The Nate Brown Show getting off to a lively start on a Thursday. That's what we always hope for, right? Off to a lively start. Packed lineup tonight. Craig Maddock coming up from Sioux Falls. Rob Motti, NFL writer, Associated Press. He's on the way from Florida. College Football on Fox. Lead analyst Brian Fisher's on tap tonight. Good stuff on a Thursday. The Nate Brown Show, South Dakota Sports Talk Show. Let's go FCS. Hey, it's Jackrabbits and Holy Cross Saturday, 10 a.m. Mountain Time start. 10 a.m. Mountain Time start in Brookings. John Stiglmeyer's on tonight, South Dakota State head coach. We've had him all season long. The Jacks 11-1 as they get set to try and advance in the FCS playoffs. Coach, good to have you back. Thanks for the time. How are you?
I'm doing super. How are you doing, Nate?
I'm doing good tonight. Congrats on the win over Delaware. Quality from start to finish, and you guys really dominated the game. What was your biggest takeaway from the opening win?
I thought, you know, there's so much talk about having 2 weeks off and rust and not being able to, you know, compete. And I thought we played at a real high level, real fast, especially our defense did. We made a couple of miscues on special teams. But other than that, we played a really good football game.
South Dakota State beat Delaware pretty comfortably, and now you're back at home against Holy Cross. I'll get into this weekend. I want to get to something that's it's not a side note. It's a great honor for you, and you've been named the FCS National Coach of the Year, Eddie Robinson Award. Eddie Robinson, the great coach, of course, at Grambling, and FCS Coach of the Year. When you got that call, that situation, what do you take? What's your takeaway when you get an honor like that?
Yeah, I think specifically in football, there are so many people, from assistant coaches to support staff to 110, in our case, 110 players. Obviously, you have to have success on the field, but every one of those contribute. They contribute to the success. So to me, it's a neat honor. It's a really neat honor. But to me, it's much more a team award, and it says something about, because this is a national award, right? It says something about how the nation feels about South Dakota State football.
When you think about your career, 26 years at SDSU, when you think about your career, who do you credit? You know, all of us kind of have mentors. How did you get to where you're at now and running this program?
You know, that's too long of an answer to the question. The answer's too long. To give you some of my most influential people, Jim Kretschmann, Dr. Jim Kretschmann up in Northern. That was my first college job, and a great mentor on how to treat people and how to coach people. Mike Daly, a guy I worked with, student coach, GA, and then as an assistant coach, taught me so much about being a coach and scheme and so on. I've written all these guys, I've thanked them all. John Gregory, who got me into coaching, who was the head coach here when I was just a student and allowed me to be a student coach, got me my first GA job in Northern Iowa. It goes on and on. A guy is average as I am. I needed a lot of help, and I had a lot of help.
John Stiglmeyer on tonight. He just won the 2022 FCS National Coach of the Year. The Eddie Robinson Award just came out. Congrats to him, Coach Stig, on tonight here on the Nate Brown Show. Let's go back to football. Holy Cross is undefeated. Some people say, well, hang on here. Yeah, the Missouri Valley's unbelievable. The Big Sky, really, really good. Those two conferences, really good. The Patriot League hasn't been one of the conferences people have noticed, but do you think it's gotten better?
There's no doubt it's gotten better. Coach Chesney at Holy Cross has done a phenomenal job, and we played him in the spring in the opening round when they had the shortened tournament, and we ended up making a run there in the spring getting to Frisco. And from then to now, his team is really, really improved and impressed. They've got an FBS win. They got a win over a CAA team, which is another really good conference. So this is a really good football team. It doesn't matter what league you're in. It's how you play football, and they play great football.
Okay, when you look at it, undefeated, as you said, if you go undefeated, that's a hard thing to do no matter what. What do you feel about the matchup? The matchup with this team and the style?
Well, they're really good in all phases, but the thing that they do and they're really committed to, and that's running their quarterback. Their quarterback is a big, strong guy. He can throw the ball. He's very much like Mark Gronowski, our guy. But they are committed. He's the leading rusher in the football team. He's rushed for over 1,000 yards. So that matchup, slowing him down, and that's always hard because it's not an option deal. It's quarterback power and quarterback swipe. So they really take a guy out of the mix, but with formations, and then get you with a quarterback like a running that's like a running back. And then their defense is really, really good. So we need to be able to move the ball, specifically run the ball.
John Stiglmeyer on tonight. Couple more. I'll let him run. Talking South Dakota State football. They're in a 10 a.m. Mountain Time game in Brookings against Holy Cross in the FCS playoffs. Last week, crowd wasn't as big as the regular season. You had great crowds, Coach, and you've worked on this. You've gotten these guys out. This whole program has revived the energy here. That stadium's been pretty full. Last week, not as big. Why do you think that is? In the playoffs, it's gone down. Attendance at the game, is it cold? What is it?
Well, I'm sure it's a number of things. Holiday season right around the corner, pheasant hunting, deer hunting, weather, all those things. But good night. I just tweeted out, we had 19,340 seats. We only had a third of that, less than a third of that. So, man, it'd be nice to get 10,000, 12,000. But you know what, Nate? Those 6,000 that showed up, they were in the game, and they really were a factor in making noise and stuff.
Yeah, I know the guys that were there were juiced and ready. South Dakota State beat Delaware, and now it's Holy Cross on Saturday. John Stiglmeyer on tonight. Last one for you, Coach. The goal is national championship. How's the health of this team, the mindset of this team? How do you feel right now?
They're very mature. We're as healthy as we've been since fall camp, to be honest with you. We're going to get back Adam Bach, at least for part of the game. Our starting Mike linebacker, all-conference player. Everybody else, for the most part, is healthy. And so that two-week bye we had going into the Delaware game was a blessing for us. So, but this is our very mature football team. They're not giddy. They're not excited. They're all business, and I can't wait for Saturday.
All right, Saturday it is, 10 a.m. Mountain Time. Jacks playing Holy Cross, 11-1 Jackrabbits against undefeated Holy Cross out of the Patriot League. Coach Stig, congrats on the award today. Good luck to you this weekend.
Thanks, Nate. Take care.
Thanks for the time. Tonight on Fox Sports Rapid City, talking Jackrabbits football. John Stiglmeyer tonight, 2022 Eddie Robinson Award winner, National FCS Coach of the Year. Big deal. Big deal. Coach Stig's been at 26th year at South Dakota State. Jackrabbits still the favorite. It looks that way. There's some teams out there you got to keep an eye on. North Dakota State, no doubt, in my opinion. Look out. There's some interesting matchups now as these FCS playoffs get a little deeper. Some interesting matchups. I like the Jacks seed here. They got Delaware, no problem. I'm not going to say it's going to be no problem against Holy Cross, but I like that much matchup in the second round. I really do. And then you get into the semis here. We'll keep you plugged in on the Jackrabbits. John Stiglmeyer's been running that show very, very good. And Jackrabbits went to Division I in 2004. Went to Division I FCS in 2004. And Coach Stig winning that National Coach of the Year Award today for the first time in program history there. Coming right back with Brian Fisher, College Football on Fox analyst. We'll talk playoff, transfer portal, the college football coaching carousel. Brian Fisher on the way.
From high school to college to the pros, this is the Nate Brown Show on 106.7 FM and 1150 AM Fox Sports Rapid City.
First Gold Gaming Resort finishes off 2022 with our biggest month of giveaways in history. Every weekend, count on winning your share of $8,600 in promo play we give away through hot seat drawings. Don't miss First Gold's lucky $7,000 cash drawings on Saturday night. And it all wraps up with our annual New Year's cash and promo play around-the-clock giveaway, December 30th through January 1st. Get contest details at firstgold.com. First Gold Gaming Resort, it's where Deadwood begins and the winning never ends.
Hi, this is Dr. Dan Jensen at Physio. We want to be your trusted partner for physical therapy, athlete development, and sports rehab. As the official strength and conditioning partners for Stevens, Central, Douglas, and the Rapid City Rush, our team at Physio is building the best athletes in the Black Hills. If you have an athlete in the family, we offer long-term athlete development at affordable prices for middle and high school students. We also have the only board-certified sports PT in Rapid City. At our brand new facility, Physio is ready to help you perform at your best. One-on-one physical therapy, athlete development, and sports rehab, all at one place. Get started at bhphysio.com.
Hey, Cobbler and Raider fans, you can now show your school spirit and earn money for your booster club. It's easy to get your Raider or Cobbler custom designed debit card today from Highmark Credit Union. Simply open a Highmark free basic checking account and get your Raider or Cobbler debit card. Plus, each swipe will earn money for your booster club. Show your school spirit and support the Raiders and Cobblers with a custom designed debit card. Visit HighmarkFCU.com.
Make a great investment this Black Friday. Renewal by Anderson's awesome Black Friday event is back by popular demand. Don't wait another day. This is incredible. 20% off every window, plus a Visa gift card for up to $1,500. No money down, no interest, no payments for 18 months. You don't pay a dime until 2024. Make a fantastic investment. Act fast. This incredible offer runs from Black Friday, November 25th through December 9th only. But don't wait. Book your free estimate right now at rbarapidcity.com. Renewal by Anderson's Black Friday sale is back.
From the kennel to the coop, whatever the season, Fleet Farm has everything to keep your animals happy and healthy. From training your pup to sit season, to mastering those retrieval skills season. From clipping your horse for competition season, to keeping the backyard birds well-fed season. And of course, loving your pets like family season. There's a reason people say, if Fleet Farm doesn't have it, you don't need it. Because we have it all. Fleet Farm. Built for real life.
In the past, if you needed auto body repair, you had to get multiple estimates and then try to get your car into a shop for repair. Well, not anymore. In most cases, you can stop by one shop, get your estimate, and schedule your car for a repair. The question now becomes which shop you choose. If you like quality, choose J&J Truck and Auto Body. They have ASE, PPG, and Gold iCar certifications that allow them to offer you a nationwide warranty. And they'll work with your insurance company so you're pleased with the outcome. J&J Truck and Auto Body, 1513 East Philadelphia.
Here at Pizza Ranch, we appreciate innovations in food delivery, like how the ancient Italians used to slingshot hot meals to hungry Romans on the go. And while we appreciate the creativity, it turned out to be, well, a little messy. So, we found a better way to bring you our legendary pizza, the country's best chicken, and our one-of-a-kind cactus bread. Just place your order online, on the phone, or on our app, and then pick it up or have it delivered right to your door. All nicely packaged in clean, sturdy, non-flying boxes. No catching necessary. Pizza Ranch. Mmm.
Being in the Army National Guard is about more than just serving your country. It's about being there for your community when your neighbors need you most. The Army National Guard makes college affordable. Serving part-time lets you attend school full-time while you take advantage of education benefits that can help you graduate debt-free. If a civilian career is your goal, serving part-time allows you to work at a full-time job. The skills, qualities, and contacts you'll develop in the Guard can open doors to a great civilian career. Want to serve, but worried about being away from friends and family? Part-time service in the Army National Guard allows you to serve close to home. Serving in the Army National Guard lets you have the life you want while you enjoy the many benefits of serving your community and nation. You owe it to yourself to learn more about how the Army National Guard can fit into your life. Visit NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the South Dakota Army National Guard. Aired by the South Dakota Broadcasters Association and this station.
Hi, it's Colin Coward. Great to be in the Black Hills. Getting the herd weekdays 10 to 1 on 106.7 FM and 11.50 AM. Fox Sports.
Welcome back in the Nate Brown Show, South Dakota Sports Talk Show, rolling on a Thursday. Welcome, Fox Sports Rapid City, 106.7 FM, 11.50 AM. Stream us all the time, foxsportsrapidcity.com. Live stream right there, packed show tonight. Always good stuff. We'll talk to Rob Motti coming up, Associated Press lead NFL writer, week 14 already. We'll get Rob Motti, get his take on the Vikes-Lions. Where are we sitting there? Vikings, the underdog on the road at Detroit. Are we buying that? Rob Motti coming up. Craig Maddock in tonight from Sioux Falls. We'll continue the Sioux Falls Rapid City sports discussion tonight. It's an interesting one. We've never really asked this question. Question of the day. We'll get back to it. Craig Maddock, SDPB Sports, on the way from Sioux Falls tonight. Brian Fisher's in. College football on Fox. Analyst. Find him on Twitter at Brian D. Fisher. College football on Fox. Brian, good to have you back. How are you?
I'm doing well, doing well.
Thanks for coming on. I appreciate your time. So, busy time, man. I'm telling you, guys are getting in the transfer portal. and coaches are getting moved and that whole thing. I want to go to a couple of the coaching moves, get your perspective. Jeff Brohm to Louisville. What do you think of that move and Louisville's hire?
Well, I think it's a great move for Louisville. You get a very proven, Big Ten head coach, somebody that obviously knows that place, has those family ties, has the, it is his alma mater. And, look, this is a move that I think has been, I don't want to say in the works for a while, but there was always kind of strong sense that at some point he would kind of come home. And, I think it made sense, just in terms of where this program was. Obviously, the opening, there was not quite the timing issues like there was initially after his first year at Purdue. So it makes a lot of sense, I think, for both sides. And, truthfully, when you look at what the operation there is at Louisville, the NIL component that they've added to things, I think it's a very attractive job, especially in the ACC where, yes, Clemson is very good right now under Abbott Swinney, but let's face it, the rest of the league, it's kind of wide open. And I think that's kind of what Jeff Brohm saw in this return to his alma mater.
Okay, I'll ask you, because Deion Sanders has been in the headlines. He's on Twitter. He's recruiting. He's hitting it hard. Colorado and Deion Sanders, were you surprised that that got done?
Not quite. I think, certainly Deion had some conversations with some other folks, but in terms of actually getting a legitimate Power 5 job, I think it kind of came down to basically Colorado. Now, could he have waited and gotten interesting in the mix of for some of these other gigs? Perhaps. But I think at the end, this was a move that kind of made sense for him. I think he will ultimately like it there in Boulder. I think that was attractive to kind of get to a very unique place in the country. And let's face it, he knows history. He knows what Colorado can do, and I'm excited to see how it all plays out. I think there's no doubt about it. There's not a huge downside in terms of Colorado. We talked more Buffs football in probably the past 48 hours, and then maybe 10 years. I think he certainly injected a lot of energy into the place, and I really can't wait to see what the next couple of years and how they play out.
Do you think now, Brian, in today's college football world, with the portal and the whole different scene, can you turn around a program quickly? I mean, in a year or two, a 1-11 team at CU. I'm not saying they're going to become USC, but can they compete quickly?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I think there's no doubt in my mind. You look, they're right there in the Pac-12. You look at what USC has done in 1 year under Lincoln Riley, using the portal very effectively, especially on offense, to get guys in there. I don't think, especially in that kind of middle-class group of Pac-12 teams, you can pick some teams off during the season, especially given the high altitude there in Boulder and the unique home environment that it provides, especially late in the season. There's no doubt in my mind that you can flip a roster pretty quickly. And truthfully, we're going to start to see that quite a bit across college football nowadays, especially now that they've loosened the number of guys that you can bring in. You just kind of got to get under that 85 limit. I think these turnaround stories, whether they're USC, Colorado, TCU making the playoff after a disappointing year last year, I think we're going to see a lot more of this just because of the way the transfer portal has worked and the way, truthfully, high school recruiting kind of building towards these moments has trailed off.
Okay, I'll ask you about more coaching news. This is being reported that Jason Garrett could be a finalist here for Stanford. What do you think about that?
I can certainly understand it from Stanford's standpoint, certainly being able to say that you've hired the former head coach of the Dallas Cowboys and Princeton grad, somebody who understands the academic components to a school like that. Definitely part of the issue. I don't think Jason Garrett is by any means the only finalist. I've heard a couple of other names, including Sacramento State's Troy Taylor. But at the end of the day, you can understand it from Stanford's perspective in terms of kind of fit and making sure you find the right guy. I just question it a lot in terms of he's never really coached in college. Really an NFL lifer, and while that worked essentially with David Shaw early on it, and Jim Harbaugh even before that, they did at least kind of come up and have some familiarity with the way things are working in college football right now. And I think that makes it a little bit more of a risk, especially considering the situation that Stanford is in right now. They're not necessarily major players in terms of NIL and getting players in there. It is difficult with the early signing period, in terms of recruiting and making sure that you have the right class. So it is a tough, tough job, and much tougher than it was 5 or 10 years ago. And to have a coach brought in there, even for as big a name as Jason Garrett is and somebody who can provide that CEO role
for the Cardinal. I think it's a big risk, and we'll ultimately see how it plays out and see what Bernard Mir, the AD there, wants to do.
Brian Fisher on, couple more for College Football on Fox Analyst. Find him on Twitter at Brian D. Fisher. I'll go to Matt Rule in Nebraska. They go 8 years, $9 million a year. Big investment, long-term deal. Is that Matt Rule hire going to be the right one?
I think so. You know, I think what Matt has been able to do, certainly over the years, really reviving the Temple program to where they can knock off, you know, Penn State occasionally, you know, what he did at Baylor, and just the manner in which he not only builds the culture there, but identifies guys. You know, you're starting to see, you know, some of his guys at Baylor make big plays on Sunday, and a lot of that is because he identifies speed. He gets the guys well coached. You know, this is a team that, you know, typically under him, he's been able to win those close games. And I think in the Big Ten, as competitive as it's going to be, you know, you need a coach like that. And I think he's going to knock it out of the park there.
Okay.
Will he reach, you know, the previous highs of Nebraska from back in the day? I don't think so, but I think he'll do very well there.
Let's go to the field. Caleb Williams, USC, just got the AP Player of the Year. Was he the best player this year?
I think so. You know, I think it'll be a bit of a coronation there on Saturday with the Heisman Trophy. And, you know, just the way he really controlled the games, you know, that was what struck out to me. Covered a couple of his games and, you know, just how masterful he was, not only operating the offense, but, you know, if the other team responded with a touchdown, he was right there to get the Trojans back the lead or get back into the ball game. So, you know, he was dazzling, you know, the way he escaped pressure and was still able to launch it downfield. And, truthfully, as we kind of saw in that Pac-12 title game with the USC defense against Utah, you know, he really had to carry you know, that USC team to this this record. And I know it was disappointing for them not to make the playoffs and not to win that game, but he was dazzling all year, and he showed it in some big moments too. I mean, he was out there certainly in Las Vegas at the Pac-12 title game, essentially playing on one leg, and you kind of saw the grit and toughness that he brought to the table as well.
All right, we're going to go to 12 teams in the playoff, Brian. A lot of people are happy. There's some that say, we should have just kept four. Where do you stand on it, going to 12?
Oh, I'm ecstatic about it going to 12. And I think, you know, talking with a lot of folks here in Las Vegas at you know, the SBAJ forum with a lot of the commissioners, I think everybody from ADs, commissioners on down, you know, I think they understand the value that, you know, having 12 teams, just the interest it's going to be, you know, late in the season. You know, when those conference championship games, you can have mid Steelers, you could have, you know, obviously teams that can play their way in. You have the opportunity to possibly host playoff games. I think the stakes in college football late in the year are going to be raised significantly because there's going to be so many more teams with that potential path for this playoff. And yes, I understand that, you know, some people might decry the fact that, we're just going to get a couple of blowouts in the quarterfinals or whatnot. And that's fine. We're already kind of getting that right now. At least, you know, this does bring the interest level around the country up. And I think ultimately, as you talk about the growth of this sport nationally, this is going to be the next kind of big wave that I think really takes college football even closer to the NFL.
Brian Fisher on tonight, College Football on Fox. He's on Twitter at Brian D. Fisher. Brian, thanks for hopping on. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Good to be out with you, Nate.
Thanks a lot. Brian Fisher tonight, College Football on Fox, college football analyst. Find him on Twitter at Brian D. Fisher, live on Fox Sports Rapid City. He says the Matt Rule hire, the right call. He thinks it's going to work out. I said I think it was the best choice that Nebraska could make there. I do. I think it's fine. I don't love the long, long deal, 8 years. I don't know why we have to go down those roads, but I think about this with the 12-team playoff field. There's one thing I was thinking about. I like it because more games will matter. You know, some people will devalue the regular season. Oh, the regular season's going to be killed. The regular season's not like any other sport in the country. We every week matters. I get it. I still think the regular season's going to be fine. Think about this. Can three teams get out of the Big Ten into the 12-team field? Could one of those teams be Nebraska in a few years? I mean, just think about that. I mean, you Husker fans, you Michigan, Ohio State, they're in control there in the Big Ten. Can Nebraska sneak in there with Penn State? You got Penn State in the mix. Wisconsin, maybe. Can Nebraska advance? Can Nebraska get in the 12-team playoff field sometime? I think it's a legitimate question. I like to expand it. More games mean more. The bowl games are a mess right now. I mean, it's a mess. When is it going to happen that teams are just going to go, hey, we lost half of our team to the transfer portal, so we can't even play in a bowl game. Good luck. When's that going to happen? I mean, we have teams decline invitations still. We have teams decline invitations to bowl games. I'm just waiting for this fact of, hey, we lost like half of our team to the transfer portal right now. We were going to go to the bowl game there in the baseball stadium, but we can't field a team. So, thanks. I'm going to get into the transfer portal here later in the drive at 5. Hang on. I've got a question of the day, just a general question of the day about the transfer portal and what you think its impact is on college sports and college football as well. Rob Motti's coming up for the first time on the Nate Brown Show, Associated Press lead NFL writer. His take on the Vikings, the Broncos, and Chiefs, all we got to discuss next.
This is the Nate Brown.
Make a great investment this Black Friday. Renewal by Anderson's awesome Black Friday event is back by popular demand. Don't wait another day. This is incredible. 20% off every window, plus a Visa gift card for up to $1,500. No money down, no interest, no payments for 18 months. You don't pay a dime until 2024. Make a fantastic investment. Act fast. This incredible offer runs from Black Friday, November 25th through December 9th only. But don't wait. Book your free estimate right now at rbarapidcity.com. Renewal by Anderson's Black Friday sale is back.
Here's your Fox Sports Rapid City forecast. Lows dip down to about 19 tonight under clear skies, westerly winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. Daytime highs approaching 46. Tomorrow, cloudy skies with a few peaks of sun. Mainly clear tomorrow night, lows level off around 23. Daytime highs approaching 44. Saturday, under mainly sunny skies, 53 Sunday. That's your forecast on the Black Hills Sports Station, Fox Sports Rapid City. Currently, it's 34.
Denny Menholt Rapid Chevrolet is looking for a few great folks to join our team. We have immediate openings for automotive techs and body shop techs. We offer a family-owned environment, state-of-the-art equipment and facilities, tool assistance, tuition reimbursement, training, paid vacation, 401k, health, dental, and vision insurance, and of course, a very competitive salary. If you're looking for a fresh start, apply in person at Denny Menholt Rapid Chevrolet or apply online at DennyMenholtRapidChevrolet.com under the Dealer Info Employment tab.
Collins Siding has been the region's premier window siding, door, and gutter installation specialist since 1974. They use only the highest quality materials and never compromise on their workmanship. Collins Siding is licensed, bonded, and their estimates always include labor, materials, and applicable permits and taxes. Collins Siding has been providing top quality service and exceeding high standards for over 45 years, and you can find out how by visiting them at 2016 Cherry Avenue. Collins Siding, 2016 Cherry Avenue, Rapid City.
Hi, this is Cody Young at High Plains Physical Therapy and Aquatic Therapy Center. I started High Plains PT in 1999, and we've been providing personalized care in Rapid City to help our patients get back in action. Remember, you have a choice for who you go to see for physical therapy. With our state-of-the-art aquatic therapy center, we are equipped to help you achieve your health goals. At High Plains, we'll give you the one-on-one treatment you deserve. We look forward to working with you at our new facility. To get started, visit highplainspt.com.
Hi, this is David Brenneman with Coldwell Banker in Rapid City. If you've considered selling your current home, let me take you to that next step with confidence. The Black Hills housing market is competitive, and I have been in the business of attracting buyers for 15 years. Let's make it happen. Contact me, David Brenneman, at 415-0044. List it, sell it, and move on. With me, David Brenneman, at 415-0044.
Imagine going through life without a supporter or a cheerleader. I was one of those kids. I grew up in a friendly home, but I needed some extra guidance, like that time I didn't do so well on my history test or when my grandfather died. I went from being a shy girl to a confident young woman getting ready to graduate with a degree in psychology. All it took was a visit from my mentor at school once a week. She transformed my life for the better. I'm Allie, and I'm a Teammates mentee. Mentor a kid like me. Go to teammates.org to learn how.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Hey, welcome back in the Nate Brown Show live, Fox Sports Rapid City, 106.7 FM, 1150 AM. Stream us there, foxsportsrapidcity.com. The Nate Brown Show also heard on podcast form. You can download it where you find your favorite podcast. The Nate Brown Show podcast available on Apple, Google, Spotify, Amazon. The list goes on. Find us there, the Nate Brown Show podcast. If you miss anybody live, catch us on the podcast. We'll get it up after the live show tonight. Associated Press lead NFL writer on the show for the first time. I've enjoyed his coverage. Rob Motti joins us live. Let's talk week 14. Already into week 14. Thursday night football tonight. Rams Raiders. Rob Motti's on Twitter. You can find him there at Rob Motti. And he's here on the Nate Brown Show. Rob, good to have you on. How are you?
Hey, Nate. How are you, man? Great to be on with you.
I'm doing good. I appreciate your time. So I want to break this thing down first tonight. What do you think about Baker Mayfield kind of being thrown around, thrown in? I said, I think he got lucky, Rob, for the situation of getting picked up by the Rams. I don't know what's going to happen in the future, but can he get in there and play tonight after being there 2 days?
It's going to be a really condensed playbook, I would think, because how much can you pick up? You know, obviously he's been in season, so it's not being in shape is not going to be a problem, but how much can you pick up of the offense? You would have to have a scaled back, limited type of package for him to be able to get in there and play. But let's be real, the Rams really had no chance, whether it's Baker Mayfield, John Wolford, Bryce Perkins, Vince Ferragamo, Sam Bradford, whoever they could throw out there in their history. Maybe short of Kurt Warner, they got no chance in this game against the Las Vegas Raiders. This is the worst defending Super Bowl champion in NFL history, and tonight they'll lose for the 10th time, which will match the, I believe it's the 99 Broncos for most losses by a defending Super Bowl champion. As you said, though, Nate, I think it's an opportunity for Baker Mayfield that we probably didn't, nobody anticipated him getting at this point. You know, he went back. He didn't win the job in Carolina. Didn't prove that he can be the guy for a team desperate for a franchise quarterback. And now he gets a chance with the Rams for, even if it's not tonight, for the remainder of the season. You would think they want to see what he can do, because there's no guarantee that Matthew Stafford is going to come back next year. He could very well retire, and they could be in the market for a quarterback.
So it's interesting. I think about the Rams and how tough this job might be. They've declined. I know the injuries and the whole thing. Sean McVay was kind of on the edge last year of coaching or not. Is Sean McVay going to stick this out?
You know, that's a great question, but that contract is going to make him want to stick it out and make that kind of – the amount of money that Sean McVay is making as a head coach, and it's hard to walk away from. Now, of course, he could probably, if he wanted, walk into a TV gig, right? We see the numbers that are thrown around for guys who come in as analysts, whether it's at Fox, and what they're planning to pay Tom Brady whenever he decides to retire at 67 years old or whatever it may be. He could probably do that, but I think he's still a competitive guy, right, Nate? Like, we see Sean on the sidelines, and as bad as this team is, he wants to win. So now he's going to get himself an opportunity where he can go from champion to, you know, first to worst, and can you rebuild that? And I would hope that he's got enough competitive juices in him that he wants to stick this out, that not the first sign of trouble, he hits the exit door and he runs out. But that possibility always exists, that's for sure.
Rob Motti is on tonight, Associated Press lead NFL writer. Find him on Twitter at Rob Motti, talking week 14. So I want to get into some games with you. A lot of Vikings fans up here. I'm a believer in the Vikings, but I think their defense is really shaky. I don't know if you can give up that many yards and points, and I just don't know, and stay where you need to be contending in the NFC. But they're 10-2, and they're underdogs at Detroit. Do you think Vegas has that right?
Nate, that one kind of blew me away. You don't often see this late in a season any team that's got that kind of a five-game advantage in division over another, an underdog. Like, you got a 10-2 team. The level of disrespect that not only Vegas and the odds makers are giving to the Vikings, but other people that you talk to around the league. Like, I just sat down with, we all know Manuel Acho now from what he does on television. He was on my AP Pro Football podcast that drops every Thursday. And he called the Vikings imposters, a 10-2 team. And it surprises me that many people, and then there are those who are believers. Like, you look at their record in one score games, and I believe it's 8-0, 9-0. It's right along those lines, right? This is a team that's lost twice. They've been blown out in both those games. I understand it was Philly was week two. It's a different kind of situation than the Cowboys. The Cowboys was a really tough, difficult loss, and if you'll recall, Dallas came into Minnesota as a favorite, and I was surprised by that line. So this line surprised me to the point where I chose the Lions because it's a Lions line. When you got a 5-7 team that's a favorite, you got to go with that. You got to go with that team as the pick. But I'm not convinced that the Vikings are frauds. I think that this Vikings team, yes, their defense, as you mentioned, it's poor and it needs help. But they got so many weapons on offense, and I know a lot of people like to jump on Kirk Cousins, and he doesn't win big games, and his prime time record and all that. I trust in Kirk Cousins to a little bit more than some other quarterbacks in the NFL. And I think with Justin Jefferson and Dalvin Cook and the weapons that they have, like, you put them in a big game, look what they did in Buffalo. Like, that to me spoke volumes about this team. So I can't say they're not for real. They're a 10-2 team. They had two terrible, awful performances against Philly and Dallas. So they're not the second best team in the NFC. They're the third best team. That doesn't mean they can't go into the playoffs, right matchup, and make some noise.
Okay, I'm going to ask you about Broncos, Chiefs. Rob, I'm going to tell you, the Nate Brown Show is an official fan page of the Denver Broncos, okay? So just be aware. And it's a rough season for me, all right? I get it. I'm saying the Broncos have a lot of things to fix. I'm not a believer that Russell Wilson has lost his all-pro ability. I think there's a lot of factors from rookie wide receivers, O-linemen, coaching scheme. I think it's all a mess. And I'm going to ask you, do you think Russell Wilson can rebound?
Nate, I'm going to tell your listeners, you and I did not pregame for this conversation, but you couldn't have picked a better person to have this conversation with right now, because I agree with you 100% on Russell Wilson. I do not believe that he is completely fallen off the map, that Russell Wilson has gone from all-pro MVP caliber type player to garbage of the NFL. I don't believe that. And I think there are other factors. And I think the coaching is an issue. I think the situation itself, just coming in there, the pressure of, you know, you look at what people were expecting from Denver, and there was talk of them being a Super Bowl contender. Then you look at the previous two seasons, Tom Brady, longtime Patriot, goes to the Buccaneers, wins in his first season. Matthew Stafford, longtime Lion, goes to the Rams, wins a Super Bowl in his first season. Some folks thought, hey, Denver and Russell Wilson, they can do the same thing. I didn't think they were going to be a Super Bowl contender. I had them as a fringe playoff team, but I also didn't anticipate a 3-9 absolute collapse. But you look at the coaching from Nathaniel Hackett and some of his just questionable decision-making throughout the season, I think that's the biggest factor. I would love to see what Russell Wilson can do, how he bounces back, how he rebounds. I think at this point, Nathaniel Hackett's got to be one and done. I'd be really surprised if he comes back. So you get Russ back in a right situation with the right coaching around him, and I bet you this guy's going to be back to Pro Bowl form next year. Yeah, I was talking to him last year, and he told me he wants to play till he's 40. All of a sudden, he's dropped off like he's the dreck of the NFL. I just don't believe that.
Okay, I'm with you. I like that. We need some positive light here of the Broncos on the show. Rob Motti on tonight, AP lead NFL writer for the first time of the Nate Brown Show. Find him on Twitter at Rob Motti. Give him a follow. Rob, good to have you. We'll do it again sometime. I appreciate you coming on.
You got it, my friend, anytime.
All right, thanks a lot. Rob Motti tonight, AP lead NFL writer. He's on Twitter. Follow him. Great coverage of the league. He has an AP Pro Football podcast at Rob Motti on Twitter. Wow. Rob Motti and Nate Brown, the only guys left that think Russell Wilson might be okay moving forward? I mean, put me on record. Can you guys do that? Can you put me on record, you know, like you put me on record for the pizza party? Remember, you put me on record for the pizza party, right? So if the Broncos finish last in the AFC West, which they're on their way, I'm going to have a pizza party for you guys, VIP listeners. We'll select them, okay? Put me on record when Russell Wilson starts playing better next year. I want you guys to come back into the show and have a little discussion, including my boy, Matt Kearney, here in studio. I might have Matt on for a nice Broncos-Russell Wilson segment. See what he has to say next season. Thanks for calling. You're live today, and you go ahead.
Hey, Nate. How you doing, buddy?
I'm good, man. What's up?
Right on. Well, you beat me to it. I was going to say, like, he might rebound, and good for him, but we're still going to get a pizza party out of the deal.
Well, you got it right this year. You got it right this year. But hang on. I want you to tell me, what's it going to be? Is Russell done, or is he going to be coming back? You tell me.
I don't think he's done. He can't be done.
Okay.
Like, he's got skill, but you're right. They do need a new coach, but I think the system in Seattle was really good for him, like his skill set and what he was doing.
Yes.
And they really helped him. Pete Carroll doesn't get enough credit for what they did. But because there was like that let Russ cook, and whenever that happened, it seemed like a couple weeks later, like, oh, no, don't let him cook. He's burning water.
Come on. Okay. So you're ready for the pizza party, right? That's what you're telling me.
Oh, 100%. Okay. 100%. Right. I might even chip in because I still owe you a steak. But anyway.
I like that. So. Thanks, buddy. Good to hear from you.
Have a good night, man.
All right. McJudgerson checking in. Yeah, I already told McJudgerson, yeah, he can come to the pizza party, okay? We got 35 slots to fill. You can come to the pizza party. Every time the Broncos lose, I get these messages from Matt Kearney, from various listeners, their pizza, you know, gifts and stuff like that. Kicking a man while he's down. It's so nice. The Nate Brown Show on a Thursday. By the way, I'm also going to go on record. The Broncos will not get blown away Sunday. They will not get blown away Sunday, okay? I'll get more into that tomorrow. Special Friday edition of the program. We're going to talk Chiefs, Broncos, Vikings, Lions, and the list goes on. But they will not get blown away Sunday. Everybody think, I mean, the Chiefs say everybody's being real cute down in KC. This is going to be an easy game, isn't it? Easy game against the Broncos, right? Careful now. Into the drive at 5. I have a question for you on the transfer portal in college sports. It's a real general question about the transfer portal. I want to know, really, when you consider everything, what is the transfer portal doing to college sports? We'll discuss next.
This is South Dakota's Sports Talk Show, The Nate Brown Show, on FoxSportsRapidCity.com and live on 106.7 FM and 1150 AM Fox Sports Rapid City.
At Black Hills Federal Credit Union, we are committed to improving the lives of our members and bettering our communities. As your community credit union, we're here to get to know you and your unique needs. From extended service hours to the newest technology, we have you covered. Stop by any location to get started or text or call 605-718-1818. BHFCU is member-owned, not-for-profit, and federally insured by the NCUA.
We're all going somewhere, going higher, faster, farther, going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Hey sports fans, it's Rob from the Firehouse Skybox. We are your headquarters for football this season. You want college football on Saturdays? Well, we have it. Join us for some great specials, and don't miss the games you want, from the Huskers to SDSU to USD. We have them all. And I know you want the NFL, so come down for $1 wing specials on Monday and Thursday nights. Then for the weekend, we'll have a great brunch buffet at the Skybox on Saturday and Sunday, with $4 Bloody Marys every Sunday. The Skybox is Rapid City's football headquarters. See you on game days at the Skybox, above the Firehouse, and downtown Rapid City.
KIMM Rapid City and K294BT Rapid City. The Black Hills Sports Station, 106.7 FM and 1150 AM. Fox Sports, Rapid City.
So, I just got the State Farm Personal Price Plan on my car insurance.
So you told your agent you play the bagpipes for your dog?
What? No, I didn't get that personal. My agent just helped me create an affordable price just for me. Okay, let me show you what I've been working on. Hey, Buster!
Contact me, State Farm agent Scott Carlson, to create your personal price plan today.
Prices vary by state. Options selected by customer. Availability and eligibility may vary.
Here's what people in need of a great automotive experience are saying about Anytime Auto Sales Service and Detail. Bob Beyer, Hermosa.
I drive into Rapid City every day and drive right by Anytime Auto. One day I needed some work done on the vehicle, and I just thought I'd stop in and give them a try. It was at that point that I met Justin, their service manager, and started talking to him about what repair my vehicle needed. And Justin really took the time to explain things to me, and I just felt really comfortable. So I began bringing my vehicles, my wife's vehicles, my kids' vehicles. They stand behind everything they do. And all those things just give you the feel of a shop that's a local shop that really cares about you. Anytime Auto Sales has my total trust. I just can't imagine taking my vehicles anywhere else. Actually, I wouldn't take them anywhere else.
There you have it. For the best in automotive sales and service, see Anytime Auto Sales Service and Detail, corner of Highway 79 in East Minnesota.
Hey, it's Chris Broussard. Remember to catch the iCouple weeknights from 6 to 8 p.m. right here on Fox Sports Rapid City. And now, let's get back to Rapid City Sports Talk Show, The Nate Brown Show.
Hey, welcome back in. The Nate Brown Show on the Drive at 5 on a Thursday. Thanks for being here. The Nate Brown Show and the Drive at 5, driven by Summit Automotive Group. SummitAutoGRP.com. When it comes to pre-owned vehicles, that's the place you want to try first. SummitAutoGRP.com. Experience the Summit difference. Stacy and Matt, a great selection right now when it comes to SUVs, trucks. Take a look. Winter's here. They've got a great selection right now. SummitAutoGRP.com. Summit Automotive Group. Craig Maddox coming up from Sioux Falls. Interesting discussion that I don't want to have with Craig. East River meets West River, our weekly segment. We've been kind of missing out here. We got to get into it. Craig Maddox, SDPB Sports from Sioux Falls. One of my questions today, I started the show with in the opening hour, does Sioux Falls have all the advantages when it comes to high school sports? Does Sioux Falls have all the advantages when it comes to high school sports? That's my question of the day. I'm going to ask Craig Maddox coming up. I'm not buying that we have to think, oh, yeah, they have resources, they have population, and they play this, you know, against these teams, and there's more people in a closer area and all that stuff. I get there's some advantage. Look at all of our teams that have competed and win on a regular basis, consistently. Stevens Track, Stevens Wrestling, Stevens Soccer. St. Thomas More girls, boys basketball, state champions. I'm not buying that Sioux Falls just, well, they have all the advantages, so everyone else around the state's kind of second, coming in second. I'm not buying that. We have some opportunities here. We'll get into it. Craig Maddox coming up. How about the transfer portal question of the day? I want to go to this. First, what do we got here on the Barron's Wilson text line? We got another pizza party text. Another. I understand. I mean, that pizza, it better taste good for you all at Poor 54 at the end of the season when the Broncos finished last. We have a little celebration, okay? And we're getting plenty of opportunities here for people to try and get their tickets secured to the pizza party. Just depends what type of mood I'm in each day when I get these pizza party messages and gifts. You know, sometimes you're in, sometimes you're out. All right, let's get into this. The transfer portal's just on fire right now in college sports, in college football. I mean, it is on fire. Here's what's happening every year in the transfer portal the last 2 years, okay? When they really opened up this thing and you could transfer, no questions asked, and the whole thing. A ton of players are entering, and not all these players are getting spots. I mean, it sounds really, really good. Player freedom, player empowerment. I'm in a bad spot. I'm going to go somewhere else, or I'm in a lower level. Now I'm going to go Power 5, and it all works out, right, for everybody. The deal is this. It doesn't. It doesn't. But I'm going, because I hear these stories that, well, ultimately the transfer portal is good for college sports because the NCAA implemented it, and instead of the red tape and bureaucratic mess that we had, and you had to get waivers and stuff, I understand. I don't want the waiver system again, the compliance offices in the middle of everything, and this kid gets to go and this kid doesn't get to go. That was a bureaucratic mess. But I'm telling you, the transfer portal being used as it is now is not the way it was supposed to be used when it comes to, okay, you get one transfer here, no questions asked. You don't have to sit out. Maybe you're in a bad, you went to this school, it wasn't what you expected. I don't believe in punishing kids, but now we got guys that are on to their third and fourth different school. They have an extra year of eligibility, and we're going to this school. I mean, we got guys in here that are looking for their third and fourth school here. So I'll ask you, there, do you think the ultimately, considering all that, I went through it, how it used to be, how it's kind of supposed to be, and giving players the opportunity to move, and also how it is, a bunch go in. We've been upwards of 15% of all players. Think about that. We've had upward numbers of 15% of all FBS players going into the portal. I mean, are we trying to say that that's what we want to, and we want guys onto their third and fourth different school? So considering everything, my question of the day is the transfer portal good for college athletics? Considering everything, okay, there's negatives to everything. There's some positives. My assessment is the way the transfer portal is being used, it's a tough one for me. I don't think it's good. I don't think it's good. You're going to have this situation where teams are just going to fall apart. I believe in teams, culture, cohesiveness, not look at me. It's all about me. I believe in a bigger cause and some loyalty. I do. And I think the transfer portal has really, really hurt that combined with the NIL. You got transfer portal and NIL money, and it's not going to help. I think it's hurting. I don't think it's good. What's your answer? We'll go to the poll question here. Thanks for calling. You're live, and you go ahead.
Hey again, Nate. I was going to mention this earlier, and we just got caught up with the pizza.
Oh. Okay.
So this is as it's being run, like you say, it's not good. So there's got to be some rails, but because it's not going away, I don't think. So we got to figure out what the rails are going to be, right?
Yes, yes. It is right. not going away. Yes.
Right. So this is radical, so I'm aware of that, but bear with me. So you need a free agency, period, right? And my thought is, if you're a freshman or a sophomore, you're still in your prove-it phase, you're in your NIL deal, whatever. Juniors and seniors can, if they've proved themselves they want to go up, or they've proved themselves and they need to go down, then as a junior or senior they can move. But they have to have an active offer from another school.
Before you decide, you have to say, hey, I have this offer and this offer. Maybe I have five offers. Who knows?
Right. And then you can go in the transfer portal. You can have those conversations and then go somewhere. But unless you have an active offer from another school, you can't enter the portal.
I don't mind that. So, I don't mind that.
That way, like you say, the kids that go in and don't get a spot, they're not out because they stayed where they stayed put.
Yeah, I got you on that. I think that would help a little bit because then you're not then you don't mess yourself up in a big way.
Right, exactly. It's kind of like, yeah, it's just looking out for them when they're not looking out for themselves.
That's a good thought, man. Anyway. I appreciate that.
Have a good night.
All right, thanks for getting in. I think you're right on one instance. I think it's very similar to how the NFL actually has a program which tries to help kids that look at, hey, I might be a draft prospect here. They have a program. They actually help the players in college decide, can you make the NFL? Okay? They actually invested in this, helping kids decide. And now, nothing's a guarantee, but the NFL has looked at it and they said, we don't want kids jumping out of college football and going to the NFL, and then they got bad advice from some agent that's their uncle. Okay? So the NFL has implemented that the last few years. They've looked at it. They said, we're going to try and invest a little bit and help these kids in college decide, hey, before you declare for the NFL draft, let's make sure you have some interest, a real prospect right now, or should you stay another year or whatever. Very similar for college football or college sports in general. Why couldn't we look at that? It would be a guardrail in there. Hey, if you have some offers on the table, work that through compliance. Work it through compliance. Then the kids can decide, yes, I've got a spot here and a spot there. Because right now, you just throw your name in. Everybody thinks they're the man. Oh, I'm the man. Everybody tells me I'm the man. They've been telling me that for 20 years. I'm the man. Right? And then you get in there and you go, well, I didn't know I was going to be third string over here. I was second string over here. Now I'm third string over here. Honestly, it's a lot of these guys haven't found homes. One thing I would say, that's the one instance I think where you're right, McJudgerson. The other one is, I don't think we can do that freshman, sophomore. Sometimes the freshmen are the guys that need to transfer. That's my only argument there. Sometimes it's those young guys that go to a place, everything was sold to them. They were sold a bill of goods. You're going to be the man. You're going to do this. Then you end up third on the depth chart. I'm not saying it's the reason to transfer, but sometimes as a freshman, you go, I didn't like this town. I didn't like the campus. I didn't like the program, and it wasn't a good fit with the coach. And I got to have it be a little open there if I'm a freshman or sophomore in the early going is my take. But I do like that thought on, do you have any offers out there before you transfer? I don't know how you get that implemented totally. What's the vote on this? Before we go to Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls, we'll have a discussion on East River meets West River here on the Nate Brown Show. Considering everything now, is the transfer portal good for college athletics? I have a lot of people tell me on Twitter and things that it's totally good. The players are in charge and player freedom, and it's all good. There's a lot of problems that come with that is my take. So here's the vote. 78% of you say, no, there's too many bad things happening. 22% of you say, yes, transfer portal, overall good. The players are now in charge. I'm with the 78%. Too many misfires. And you get into the portal, things don't work out. Now you're going, okay, I guess I'm going to go into the portal again. And you got to, I mean, these kids are impressionable. They're young, trying to find their way. Adversity comes, and the next thing I do is, well, I can get out. Adversity comes, I can get out. And we make it so easy. So that's one of my big issues with it. So easy to get out. Craig Maddox in. Next, SDPB Sports. Does Sioux Falls have all the advantages when it comes to high school sports? Is that why they have been winning? Am I going to argue with Craig? Next? Maybe.
Did you miss an interview or great segment on The Nate Brown Show? Just find The Nate Brown Show podcast and listen wherever you download your podcasts.
Have you hit a pothole or curb with your car? Does your vehicle need an adjustment or have an alignment, shock, or strut issue? Black Hills Tire is your one-stop shop for complete automotive service and repair in the Black Hills area. Trust your vehicle with no one else but Black Hills Tire. Contact Weston, Tenise, and the guys at Black Hills Tire, where honesty, reliability, and safety is their top priority. Black Hills Tire, voted the number one shop for automotive repair and brake repair and tire store in the Black Hills. Ask about their free pickup and delivery. Black Hills Tire. Check them out online at blackhillstire.com.
Here's your Fox Sports Rapid City forecast. Lows dip down to about 19 tonight under clear skies, westerly winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. Daytime highs approaching 46. Tomorrow, cloudy skies with a few peaks of sun. Mainly clear. Tomorrow night, lows level off around 23. Daytime highs approaching 44. Saturday, under mainly sunny skies. 53 Sunday. That's your forecast on the Black Hills Sports Station, Fox Sports Rapid City. Currently, it's 32.
All right, Rapid City, one of my favorite places is Poor 54 downtown. If you're looking for the best place to have a cold one with friends, maybe date night with your wife, or just go and watch the big game with some buddies in their great sports area upstairs, Poor 54 has it all. Plus, 54 taps of beer from local and regional breweries, and it's self-serve. You don't have to wait around. You can get what you want right away. And the food's out of this world. I love the Detroit-style pan pizzas. Check out Poor 54. You'll love it. Downtown Main Street.
What can Elevate Performance do for your athlete? Brandon Drum, D2 lacrosse player at Mars Hill University.
I started going to Elevate Performance for problems with my knee, and after working with Britt, he identified some other issues that helped me prevent severe injury. Elevate's strength and conditioning program also helped me perform at a much higher level. My goal was to play college lacrosse, and I am thankful for Britt and Elevate for helping me achieve that goal. Elevate worked with me on a personal level and helped mold me into a stronger athlete.
Get your athlete started at Elevate Performance. SD.com.
Honda True. Discover three tiers of vehicle coverage that work for you. Only at Denny Menholt Rushmore Honda. The inspection is just the beginning. Honda Certified Pre-Owned means peace of mind with incredible benefits like 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain coverage, up to 2 complimentary oil changes, 24/7 roadside assistance, inspection report, and 3-day exchange option. Check out all the benefits and search inventory at honda-true.com or come by Denny Menholt Rushmore Honda in Rapid City.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Welcome back into the Drive at 5 on the Nate Brown Show, South Dakota Sports Talk Show. Good stuff on a Thursday tonight. Great guests across the board. We had Coach Stig on earlier, South Dakota State head football coach in the opening hour. If you missed parts of the show, catch the podcast. Some great guests across the board in opening hour and hour number two, of course. But you might only catch 10, 15 minutes on your way home. Catch the Nate Brown Show podcast. We don't repeat segments or guests, record stuff, play it back, and you know, take 10 minutes off, try and give you new content, but understand you can't catch it all. So go to the Nate Brown Show podcast. All the guests are right there. Find us where you download your favorite podcasts, like In Play from Craig Maddock. That's his podcast, In Play from SDPB Sports. Craig Maddock's on tonight from Sioux Falls. Craig, good to have you back on. How are you?
Hey, I'm not too bad. I got a little bit of a cough, so I got to apologize for your listeners. By the way, a little note to put down for your bosses there, Mr. Brown.
Yeah.
Maybe some of those who are in the sales and marketing aspect of your great radio station. This might be of some help. During the state volleyball tournament, I was approached by a listener of yours there at West River, certainly in the Rapid City area, and they ran into me. They came to me specifically to tell me that they loved hearing me on your radio program.
Whoa! Wow.
So I just, they didn't say anything about you, but they said they enjoyed it when I was on. So just letting you know in case that
quality
might help anybody in the, I agreed with them. So I believe that.
And just how much money can we make off this segment? That's what I want
not
to know.
Much. That, okay. Not much. Just listen. The listen is good enough.
Okay, I like it.
Thank
By
you.
The way, let's Thank dig you. Into this. I have a question that everybody's fired up on today. I didn't mean to do this, but it's Twitter. You know, it's not real life. So it's Twitter, and everybody argues and carries on and everything. So I talked to a college athlete out here yesterday. He's from East River. He's from the Sioux Falls area. Played college football, but now he's out here in Rapid City, and he's been doing things with athletes out here for the last few years. He told me yesterday, he said, you know what? I mean, East River's great. We have great athletes, great culture, and the whole thing. He goes, you know what people don't understand? Rapid City is full of great athletes, great players in various sports. He said the rest of the state doesn't see it, and Rapid City maybe doesn't put it all together in football, but he said there are a ton of good athletes out here. And it got me thinking, Craig. I said, I'm going to ask this question of the day. Everybody makes excuses around South Dakota that says Sioux Falls is better because of Sanford, because of a population. Sioux Falls just has all the advantages. Do you think that's the case? Is that why Sioux Falls is better? There's more advantages across the board.
Well, you have to compare the advantages to whom? To Rapid City?
Rapid City? Anybody.
To Wall? To no. Parkston? To
Rapid City?
Mitchell.
Yankton? Mitchell? Yeah.
Well, I agree that Sioux Falls most likely have more programs available to the area athletes. Facilities-wise, there's a few more, but have you been to a Brookings to see what a facility their athletes use up there? Have you been to Yankton to see what they do? Have you been to Aberdeen, what they do for the area? Watertown is building a brand new football stadium. You look what Pierre is doing. To me, Sioux Falls gets the advantage at times because of, okay, with bigger population, there are more programs. But when it comes to, let's say, facilities like weight rooms and stuff like that, Harrisburg has a great weight room. T area does. And this is for all of the athletes. I'm not speaking just for football. There are, you go out to Wall. My gosh, great facility there. So as far as if coming to the athletes at their own hometown, do they have opportunities to get better with programs, with facilities? A lot of towns do, but it's certainly not on the size that Sioux Falls has.
Okay.
And it's because we have a much bigger population.
Okay, I would get that. I said, I know Sioux Falls has some advantage of being really good at high school sports with population. With sheer numbers comes, you know, the best of the best. And the resources Avera, Sanford have put in, that's made a difference, no doubt.
And Monument Health, they put them in there.
Sure. That's
and,
what I mean.
You know, Avera up at Aberdeen, sure.
I don't think Sioux Falls has all these advantages, and that's why they've had some success in whatever sport, football and various sports. I don't believe that they have more of everything. But 85% of my audience is saying, yes, Sioux Falls just has more of everything. End of story.
Well, let's just do football for a quick second. Where was Roosevelt in Washington this year based in football, AAA football this
year? Not very good.
Right near Rapid City Central. Not very good. But, and I've told you this in the past, every school has that roller coaster ride of athletes in the particular grades, and both those schools have been on an amazing run over the years. And it did hurt with Jefferson being formed. I mean, they're the ones that benefited the most because they were able to take most of the kids away from Roosevelt.
Yes.
But that wasn't because of greater athletic facilities, even though Jefferson has a pretty good one.
Okay, so I'm fighting the good fight. I believe sometimes you can get into excuses. And I even went through the list because I said, Stevens wrestling, they win. Stevens track, they win. Stevens boys soccer just won a state title. The girls soccer was in the state championship last year.
Yep. Yeah, I agree.
STM girls and boys basketball, they've won over the years. I said, I'm not buying Sioux Falls is just going to be the best of the best because they have this, they have that. I think other towns can do just as much. All right.
Well, I think they are. There are towns are doing that. Look, I mean, I mentioned Wall, the facility they have with a nice football field. Towns are looking at the infrastructure and the advantages of their kids and the programs that they can build for their kids. But a lot of that takes hometown sponsorship. And if hometown mom and dad pop shops and whatever other corporate companies you may have in your town, you get them riled up in support of your high school, that's going to help the athletes.
Yeah, I'm with you. Community buy-in. I believe that. I think Sioux Falls has a big buy-in. For a big city, they got buy-in on the sports side. I believe that. Okay, Craig Maddock on SDPB Sports from Sioux Falls. Quick question here. High school head coach. If you're a high school head coach, do you need to be on social media to connect and relate with your players in 2022?
No, I do not.
Huh?
In fact, I think head coaches don't need to be on Twitter, because if he needs to get in touch with them, he's got their own phone number. He can call them and talk to them. High school kids don't need their coach on social media to be hip.
What about
in their book?
What about promoting your team, your brand? Everybody
has
a brand.
That, but you can do that. But as far as the coach himself, hey, I've run into a lot of coaches, and they don't want to have anything to do with social media. They want their athletes off of social media. If they're on social media, the coaches, it kind of gives players free rein to do whatever they want on social media, and it can get them in trouble.
I hate to break it to you, but the kids are going to be on social media anyway. Anyway,
yeah.
Coach, so you need to get there. Relate to them. I flipped on that. I think they should be on there. By the way, last one for Craig Manick. John Stiglmeyer was on tonight, South Dakota State. They're playing Holy Cross, FCS playoffs Saturday. What's the deal? The crowd was really good this regular season. High numbers, 14,000 average. Drop down, it's down to 5,000-6,000.
Mm-hmm.
It's cold. That's happened over the years. When the Jacks are in the playoffs, the crowd drops by 10,000. What's the deal?
Well, part of it is, during the regular seasons, the season tickets only go to the end of the regular season. And those that have bought season tickets then would have to buy the individual playoff tickets. And history has shown that the attendance has gone down dramatically, unless it's North Dakota State that is coming to Brookings. It'll be very interesting. It should be a decent weekend for weather-wise this weekend. But you know what? I don't think some state fans get excited about Holy Cross coming to Brookings.
Yeah. Well,
if they
could
make it to the semifinals, I would expect a pretty big crowd if the weather is good.
Okay. So it's got imagine those expectations. Well, if we make it to the semifinals, we'll come. But other than that, we're out. Support the Jacks.
Funny.
Support the Jacks.
Well, I know. So history has shown, though, attendance is down. But if people want to see one of the best teams the Jacks have ever had, this is where you got to go.
Okay. 10 a.m. Mountain Time start on Saturday. It'll be on ESPN, by the way, Jackrabbits Holy Cross. Craig Manick on tonight. I just saw on your new in-play podcast, a great coach. Speaking of taking teams to state, he did it all the time, Dusty LeBeau.
I love talking to Dusty. I've known him a long time, and I respect him so much for what he has done and what he has meant for the Pine Ridge schools that he has been at over the last 26 years. You know what? 19 different teams over 26 years, boys and girls, to the state tournament, and what he's been as a mentor to those kids. It's a fun interview. Dusty opened up a lot. He's kind of a quiet guy, you know.
Yep.
He's a little bit of a quiet guy, but he came on strong, and I hope that you go to SDPB Sports on Twitter or Facebook, click In Play with Craig Manick, and Lyle Dusty LeBeau is my guest, and he doesn't really know where the name Dusty came from.
Interesting. Great coach.
Where did the Dusty name come from? He goes, I don't know.
I covered him a lot as well. Had some great teams. Craig Manick, In Play, the podcast. Download it. Craig on tonight. And he told us Sioux Falls isn't quite the best at everything. I mean, it's amazing. But you're close. Craig, thanks for coming on.
All right, Nate. See ya.
I appreciate it. Craig Manick tonight, SDPB Sports. Sioux Falls. Let's go NFL Pick'ems. Next on the Nate Brown Show, Rob Kegron, his five NFL winners on the way.
You're listening to the Nate Brown Show. Follow us and watch the show live on Twitter at Nate Brown Show.
First Gold Gaming Resort finishes off 2022 with our biggest month of giveaways in history. Every weekend, count on winning your share of $8,600 in promo play we give away through hot seat drawings. Don't miss First Gold's lucky $7,000 cash drawings on Saturday night. And it all wraps up with our annual New Year's cash and promo play around the clock giveaway, December 30th through January 1st. Get contest details at firstgold.com. First Gold Gaming Resort, it's where Deadwood begins and the winning never ends.
For nearly 100 years, Connex has been providing the know-how and materials to help their neighbors grow. Through partnerships with builders, homeowners, and contractors, Connex Home Centers have impacted our communities, making them stronger and safer through support of local organizations and neighborhood beautification projects. Improving the quality of life for others is important to us. We are Connex Home Center, your hometown lumberyard, lending a helping hand in building our communities since 1928.
Where can you get surprisingly great rates on auto and renter's insurance? At State Farm. I'm State Farm agent Matt McCormick, and I'm your one-stop shop in Rapid City for protecting your car and your stuff for surprisingly great rates. So stop looking around. Call me, State Farm agent Matt McCormick, for surprisingly great auto and renter's rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Individual premiums will vary by customer. All applicants subject to State Farm underwriting requirements.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio, sales, service, and recreation, this is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Welcome back into the Drive at 5 on the Nate Brown Show, South Dakota Sports Talk Show. Lively debate tonight. Always good stuff. Had some South Dakota State talk with head coach John Stiglmeyer joining us live from Brookings. Jackrabbits Holy Cross Saturday, 10 a.m. on ESPN. Good highlight game there, man, on ESPN. South Dakota State, that's big time. Rob Motti tonight, AP lead NFL writer, breaking down week 14. And you know it's a Thursday with the Firehouse Skybox. Football Pick'ems Thursday, five games from Rob Kegron here on Fox Sports Rapid City. Rob, good to have you, man. How are you?
I'm doing great, Nate. Great to be with you again.
Let's get rolling. Here we go. This is the game that I know I shouldn't say it. I think the Vikings win. Vegas says no. Lions are favored by 2 over the 10-2 Vikings.
One of those lines, Nate, where you kind of twist your head and figure out, what am I missing in this game? What am I not understanding about this game? Why is Detroit a 2-point favorite? I get that they've played well over the last number of weeks. But are people not taking Minnesota seriously? They've had 2 losses, and they were bad losses. But other than that, they've been in every single game. And the one thing about the Lions is they give up points. They give up 27 points per game. So even though they have some offensive weapons, I just don't see them stopping Minnesota. It's a close game. It's a divisional game on the road for Minnesota. But I'm going to take the 2 points, and obviously I'm going to take them on the money line. I agree with you. I think the Vikings win this game outright.
You do. It'll be interesting, man. Vegas says no. Vikings going on the road against the Lions. Okay. Rob Kegron's a Giants guy. Are the Giants still in this thing? It looks to be the case. They've cooled off a little. Giants are 6.5-point dogs at home against the Eagles. Always a big one.
Didn't love the tie last week against Washington, Nate, but they are still in it. Amazingly, they are still in it. And even if they were to lose this game, they'd still be in it because they play Washington in a little more than a week here. And if they were to beat them, they'd have the upper hand going down the stretch to get that playoff spot. But in my mind, the Giants' rush defense just isn't good enough to compete with a team like Philly. They give up 5.1 yards per carry. I mean, the one thing we know about Philly, Nate, is that Jalen Hurts can run, and he runs a lot, and he runs effectively. I even in a close divisional game, I think Philly is going to win this. And the 4 losses that the Giants have, Nate, they've all lost by at least 7 points. Mm. So as much as I hate doing this, I'm going to be true to trying to pick winners here. Okay. Take Philly minus 6.5.
You are. The hook as well. Philly is way better than I thought. I was late to the party on that, and they're the real deal. Rob Kegron, Skybox, downtown above the Firehouse, your football headquarters this weekend. Here we go. Chiefs at my Broncos. We're back in the lineup. They flexed us out of Sunday Night Football. I'm going to tell you, Rob, they're going to regret it. That's going to be a closer game than people think. But what do you say? Broncos 9-point underdogs in Denver.
Nate, you are such an optimist. If this game was being played in my backyard, I would draw the blind.
Oh, come on.
I would not watch, Nate. 13.8 points per game for the Denver Broncos this year. Dead last in the NFL. their defense is great, and we all know that. And they lost another heartbreaker last week against Baltimore, against the backup quarterback, mind you. I don't see how they stop Mahomes. I get that the defense is very good, but you can only slow down Mahomes. You can't stop him. And to be able to do something in this kind of game, you're going to have to score some points, and I don't see how the Broncos are going to be able to do that. I hate giving up 9 points on the road, but I think Kansas City will get to Russell Wilson, and I think they'll turn the ball over them on a couple of times, and I could even see Kansas City only scoring, 21, 24 points and still covering. 24-10, Kansas City lay the 9 points.
All right, I knew that was coming. Everybody's jumping on that. Look out, I'll roll with the Broncos, ride or die here, and we're dying a lot. Bucks at 49ers. This is the Bucks have not been the real deal. 49ers, Brock Purdy at quarterback, 3.5-point favorites at home.
Tampa, an amazing comeback victory against the Saints when they looked dead in the water almost the entire game. You never can count out Tom Brady, as we absolutely know. Brock Purdy, he did not play a bad game against Miami, but this is going to be a battle of defenses, obviously. The over-under in this game, Nate, is 37.5. And when I see a number that low, and I have a guy on the other side who's the underdog, who's the greatest quarterback of all time, I think it's going to be a close game. And so I'm going to take the 3.5 points. I can see San Francisco eking out a victory. But to me, this is a 20-17, 17-14 game, something like that. There's a lot of defense in this game. And the one thing about Tom Brady is he doesn't turn the ball over. So as good as San Francisco's defense is, if you can't turn the opposing quarterback over, I think you have a really good case for the underdog, and so I'm going to take the 3.5 with Tampa Bay.
Okay, Bucks 3.5 plus 3.5. Last game with Rob Kegron, downtown Firehouse Skybox football headquarters in Rapid City. Dolphins Chargers are into the Sunday night matchup. Chargers are 3.5-point underdogs. What do you say about Tua against Herbert?
You know, Nate, the Chargers are one of those teams you can almost never trust. They never do what they're supposed to do when they're supposed to do it. But I like the hook here. I like the 3.5 points. I think Miami showed a lot of their flaws last week, and Tua definitely did not have a good game. And I think Herbert is due for a big game. He has a lot of his offensive weapons back. Keenan Allen's back. We obviously know what Austin Eckler can do on the field. I just don't really trust Tua right now. And I think the fact that you're getting 3.5 at home against a Miami team that is very good but not great. They're not elite. Yep, they're not in the same category as Kansas City, Cincinnati, or Buffalo. I'm going to take the 3.5, and I think the Chargers know that this is a must-win for them. They have to win the game if they're going to have any chance at a playoff spot. I'll take the 3.5 points in the Chargers.
Rob Kegron, tonight, the Skybox is the place, man. You got to get there. Thursday night football tonight, and then I said it, Jack's playing on Saturday. People say, oh, college football's over. No, it's not. Jack's Saturday and then a good NFL Sunday.
Yeah, Nate, we were excited last week for the South Dakota State's first playoff game. We had a good crowd for that. This is a 10 a.m. game on Saturday morning. We'd love to see people out there. Bloody Mary's plenty. Let's beat an undefeated Holy Cross team, and then we got a full slate of NFL games. We had a huge crowd last Sunday. Let's keep it rolling. Keep the momentum going for all the big games this weekend, Vikings, Broncos, and the Sunday night game, of course, as well.
You want some great food, they've got it, some great specials. The Skybox, where we go downtown above the firehouse. Rob Kegron tonight. Rob, enjoy the weekend.
Thanks, Nate. You too. Take care.
All right, Rob Kegron tonight. The Firehouse Skybox. If you haven't taken your friends, family, take them. Enjoy football weekend. Jack's on Saturday, NFL Sunday, and my Broncos keeping it close with the Chiefs on Sunday afternoon. Now, mind you, I haven't said the Broncos are going to beat the Chiefs, okay? Yeah, I'm not that crazy. If you're a high school senior, get this. If you're a high school senior, the last time the Broncos beat the Chiefs was when you were in fifth grade. That's a sad story. A sad story. Chris Stabner is next. Stevens head boys basketball coach. What's the roster look like after losing a bunch of starters? Chris Stabner on the way.
You're listening to the Nate Brown Show.
Make a great investment this Black Friday. Renewal by Anderson's awesome Black Friday event is back by popular demand. Don't wait another day. This is incredible. 20% off every window, plus a Visa gift card for up to $1,500. No money down, no interest, no payments for 18 months. You don't pay a dime until 2024. Make a fantastic investment. Act fast. This incredible offer runs from Black Friday, November 25th through December 9th only. But don't wait. Book your free estimate right now at rbarapidcity.com. Renewal by Anderson's Black Friday sale is back.
Here's your Fox Sports Rapid City forecast. Lows dip down to about 19 tonight under clear skies, westerly winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. Daytime highs approaching 46. Tomorrow, cloudy skies with a few peaks of sun. Mainly clear. Tomorrow night, lows level off around 23. Daytime highs approaching 44. Saturday, under mainly sunny skies. 53 Sunday. That's your forecast on the Black Hills Sports Station, Fox Sports Rapid City. Currently, it's 32.
Well, at Black Hills Health and Wellness Center, we have four chiropractors in the clinic, and our big focus is working on the musculoskeletal health of patients. Being in business in 39 years and having done business with every single bank in the area, in the community, in the last 2 years, we have definitely realized how much we have been missing out with the extra go-the-distance service that Pioneer Bank and Trust is willing to provide you. Pioneer Bank and Trust is local.
Pioneer Bank and Trust. Member FDIC.
Live from the Anytime Auto Sales Service and Details Studio. Sales, service, and recreation. This is Fox Sports Rapid City.
Welcome back in the Nate Brown Show, South Dakota Sports Talk Show. Local sports newsmakers here on the program. Our high school basketball previews rolling through them. High school basketball season's here, man. It came up quick. We had Stevens girls coach on last night, Adam Dannenbring. They just won Monday night. Stevens girls playing at home tomorrow and Saturday. The Stevens boys on the road. Stevens boys going to Pier tomorrow and Aberdeen Central Saturday. Chris Stabner's the head coach at Rapid City Stevens. Here on the Nate Brown Show, getting the season started. Coach, good to talk to you. How are you?
I'm doing all right, Nate. Thanks for having me.
Well, I appreciate it. Let's talk hoops here. I look at it. I covered you guys last year. Lost a lot of players that contributed, a lot of starters. So when that happens to you, sometimes it's like, well, who do we have coming up here? And when you look at the guys stepping in here, what type of players do you see?
Well, there's no doubt we're inexperienced. I mean, my first time in my 8 years that we have, you know, not one guy returned that really played any varsity minutes, you know, just a little. So we got some green guys, you know, young guys that are going to really go through the fire early. You know, my hope is, you know, the team you see Friday, Saturday night, by the end is a whole lot different, just because of, I think, the growth that these guys are going to take because of the inexperience and because of, you know, the not knowing. The hope is by the end we're playing a lot better. But the one thing I'll say about this group is, you know, we're not real big, and we've still got a ways to go as far as learning how to play at the AA level, but they're thirsty for coaching, and they've competed almost every day in practice because, you know, number one, everybody's fighting for a role because nobody really had one coming back. But the other thing is, you know, they're looking to, they know they need to get better, and they're looking for coaching and wanting coaching. If they can continue to do that, I there's no doubt we're going to grow by the end.
That's a big thing. Getting coaching, right? Wanting coaching. But a big thing I say, okay, when I haven't played varsity, what do you tell them is, okay, from JV or sophomore, whatever they were on, what's the big difference when you go varsity starting up tomorrow night?
Yeah, I think it's just kind of the urgency, the physical play, the speed of the game. It's all different. And that's, you know, you can tell them that. You can try to prepare them for that. But, you know, when the ball gets tipped tomorrow, they'll kind of get thrown in the fire. And you know, some will hold their own, and some may sink a little bit, but that's okay. Like I said, as long as we go over there and compete, that's the biggest thing tomorrow. You know, it's not necessarily winning or losing. I mean, obviously, the round of 16, you know, they're all important, but more importantly for us is, you know, can we go over and compete and just grow? You know, even if it's a little step tomorrow and build some confidence in these guys, that's going to be the biggest thing.
Okay, I know how you coach. You want defense, a lot of man-to-man, a lot of high-pressure stuff. When you look at this team, offensively and defensively, what type of team here? Offensively, can we shoot it? You say we're not very big. Can we shoot it? Defensively, can we pressure?
You know, I'd like to think we can shoot it. You know, we've shot it pretty well in practice. You know, that's one thing last year that just, you know, unfortunately, we had shooters, but we just did not shoot the ball well at all. So I think this is a team that can shoot it. We've got some, you know, playmakers as far as creating. You know, we're not very big, though. So then, in turn, you know, we've got to really be disciplined is what we have to be, and that's what we've been stressing. Take care of the basketball. Use jump stops, you know. Be able to get high percentage shots, you know, especially when you're not making your outside shot. But there's no doubt we're going to knock down. You got to knock down threes too. So I think that's a team that can do that. You know, we'll see. You know, we're going to get pressured like crazy tomorrow. Can we handle the pressure? So really, the verdict's still a little bit out on all of that. You know, with most of them really just kind of being new to our system, we're going to hopefully play hard. Make up for some of our mistakes tomorrow. Obviously, we always want to defend and rebound because, you know, when we're not shooting well, those got to be staples. So hopefully we do that. And, you know, I'll probably have a better answer for you come Monday.
Yeah, I know it's first weekend. A lot of things are going to happen. You got to break into this puppy. You break in against Pierre tomorrow night. They have Lincoln Keenholz, an all-state player. I mean, he's going to be a college football player in the Pac-12 right now. But he's a great athlete. When you look at a player like that on the hard court, what do you see tomorrow night?
Yeah, I mean, he's arguably, you know, one of the best athletes to ever come out of South Dakota. I mean, he could probably play three sports at the Division I level. And the one thing about him, he's just such a complete player. And, you know, not only can he, you know, put it on the floor, shoot the three, but he's very unselfish, you know. And when teams show him the attention or double team him, he's willing to give it up and find the open guy. He's really good at that too. So, you know, you kind of try to pick your poison. Yeah, I mean, we can, you know, try to run guys at him, but he's going to probably find the open guy too. So he is just a complete player, but, you know, unfortunately he's not the only thing they have either. You know, they have the Edmund kid that's a Division II basketball player, very athletic, left-handed. And then, you know, like always, they have guys that just play their roles and play hard. So, yeah, there's no doubt it's going to be a stiff test for us. But it's just, like I said, it's a measuring stick for us just to kind of see where we're at. And the number one thing I'm just going to tell the guys is, and I have been telling them, let's go compete. You know, you're going to make mistakes. We know that. We're not going to be perfect. You can compete. So that's what we're challenging the kids to do with this, both games. You know, both games are going to be tough.
Brand new five starters in the mix for the Raider boys. The head coach at Stevens is Chris Stabner on tonight. They're at Pierre tomorrow night. Coach, good luck to you. Thanks for coming on.
All right, Nate. Thanks for having me.
I appreciate it. We'll talk Raider basketball all season long. Keep you plugged in on High School Hoops. Stevens boys on the road at Pierre against Lincoln Keenholz. Great player. He's an athletic player, man. He's going to be a college football player, but great guard, can shoot it, puts it on the floor. Pierre tomorrow, and then Aberdeen Central. They've had a good team. Aberdeen Central had a good team last year, and they'll play them Saturday. Raider boys on the road. We're back tomorrow on a Friday on the Nate Brown Show. Friday edition. Catch the podcast. It's going up tonight. Good show tonight. Thanks for being a part of it. The Odd Couple's on the way next.
Here's what you need to know. 15.